This is Jay Parker. He's going to tell us a little bit about the PC and what he does in Dell.
Hi, my name is Jay Parker, and I'm responsible for our client product group at Dell. That means both for consumers as well as business customers, we define and deliver the products that you see here today.
Okay, so we have heard about that the PC is dead for a while, but we still see it in the market. So what's going to happen, Jay?
Yeah, well, the announcement of the death of the PC was very premature. As a matter of fact, we're seeing more innovation in the PC today than we've seen in years. And that's evidenced by the fact that even the highest priced PCs above $1,000 are growing faster than any other segment of the market. I think that's the testament to the type of innovation that we're seeing in the devices, that they're attracting a whole new set of customers.
Okay, so is the desktop still rules, or is the laptop, is the desktop still ruling in the market, or is the people buying more laptops?
Well, you know, for many years, laptops have been growing faster than desktops. But you also need to know that desktops in the commercial space still make up about half of the market. So there are two viable categories that appeal to different customer sets. But the laptops are growing, as evidenced by the fact that really the way that we use our personal devices and the way that we work has transformed over the years. You know, work is really an activity now and not a place we go. We want to be able to be productive from anywhere, and mobile technology allows us to do that.
Okay, so is the future going to be mobile as a smartphone, or are we going to still see the laptops for a while?
Yeah, you know, there was a belief at one point that the smartphone would be the computing device of choice, but I think that just wasn't realistic, and we're seeing that in the way that the market is manifesting itself today. The fact is, to be productive, either in your personal life or at work, you really need a PC. That is the center around which our technology universe is built. And so, as we go forward, we expect the PC market to be stable as it has been. We expect more innovation and more investment in this space, and we'd like to believe that Dell will be leading that.
Okay, and where are we going to see that innovation? In which part of the market?
Well, I think you'll see innovation across the PC market, especially in the mobile PC space. For the next few years, we expect that innovation will be, I'll say, evolutionary. If you look back 10 years ago and PCs that we developed and now, you'd hardly recognize what we did 10 years ago, but it's happened gradually. Design has gotten better, the aesthetics have gotten better, the form factors and sizes, the materials, the quality, the battery life, that will continue to get better over the next several years, to the extent that I think we'll have infinity edge displays, we'll have 24-hour battery life, we'll have seamless connectivity that includes 5G, and those are exciting developments that that bode well for the PC market.
Okay, and when are we going to see that lightness, that kind of lightness that we see in the movies?
The kind of what?
Sorry. Lightness, like really small computers.
Oh.
Really light.
Well, you know, the computers you see in the movies are often Dell computers, I have to say. So I have to believe that today we're already seeing those very thin and light, but it's going to continue to get better. We use new materials like machined aluminum. We have very thin displays, and that'll continue to happen. Now, I will say that we do see a point in the future where the keyboard is not even the primary input device for the PC. You know, the keyboard was invented over 150 years ago, and we still use it today. But with the advent of voice recognition, of touch displays, of pen inputs, of gestures and eye tracking, we believe that more natural inputs will be the primary device of the PC. So we could see a time 5 to 10 years from now where you have a PC with two displays or even a folding display, and you interact with it in a way different than we do today.
Okay, so are we going to see improvements security-wise, like for example in the interfaces? Because right now we have like a face recognition, fingerprint recognition, even iris recognition. What else is coming?
Yeah, I think from a device security perspective, you know, that secures the hardware and the endpoint, it'll remain very much the same. But the where we see the real innovation is in security of the data and tracking the data, both inside your network if you're a corporate customer or even outside of your network. And that's where not only does Dell provide opportunities around the devices, but we also have security suite software that enables you to secure your data outside of the device and even outside of the network. Combine that with some of the strategically aligned businesses within the Dell Technologies families like RSA or SecureWorks, and we believe we'll have a holistic package to allow customers to secure their environment in, you know, a world that's only getting more dangerous.
Okay, so these days everybody is thinking about what happens with the devices once they get to the end of their actual life. So what can you tell us about that?
Yeah, well, I guess there's a few points on that. The first part is Dell has been a leader in sustainability of the materials that we use in both our packaging as well as our products. We're using recycled plastics for our packaging that are derived from the ocean, as an example. We're using recycled gold from motherboards to put back into motherboards of new computers. There's actually a ton of gold on the average PC motherboard, and we're using recycled carbon fiber in our chassis in many cases. So there's an element of sustainability and recyclability of the product, number one. Number two is that, of course, Dell has and has for many years had asset recovery services where we will take back your PC assets in exchange for new ones, and then we will dispose of those either through the resale market or in an environmentally friendly way. The last thing I'd say is that we're seeing PC as a service, as a business model, really starting to take off. We had an announcement back in October where we combine our devices and the software and applications along with our services, and you just pay by the month, which means that really you're renting those products, for lack of a better way to say it, and as part of that, we'll take care of the recovery of the devices at the end of the life as you determine it.
Okay, it seems like you and your team has everything figured out. What's the biggest challenges that you guys have?
Well, you know, I would not say we have it all figured out. We are certainly proud of our business and our products, but I think, you know, as the world progresses and as people are looking to solve some of the world's challenges with more and more data and compute power, it's really incumbent upon us to make products that meet those customer needs and that make it easy and efficient for them to solve the challenges that they want to solve. So that's really what we're doing, is trying to keep up with our customers at the end of the day.
Okay, thank you very much.